everyone. I'm so happy you're here today. We're going to be making a fun flat fold card, and we're making this cute little dog one. Hi Stampers, this is Dawn, and today we're going to be making a fun fold card, and we're using the brand new Christmas Scottie for the card. Isn't it cute? So this is the way the card sits when it's closed, and then when you open it, it has this little flap on the inside. Isn't that adorable? And then I made this one using the Hippest Hippos, which is a free celebration set. Both of these stamp sets will be available on Friday, July 1st, so it's just in a day or so. But this is the Hippest Hippos, which is a celebration item you can get for free. And then you open it, and then you have the greeting on the inside right there. Isn't it adorable? Okay, so now both of these stamp sets, this one, it comes with a coordinating die, which you can also get during celebration for free when you spend a $50 order. So you can get the hippos and the die collection that coordinate. And then also the Christmas Scottie stamp set, which looks like this, comes in a bundle with the Scottie Builder Punch. So cute. All right, and then this one is in the holiday catalog that also starts on Friday. All right, so let's go ahead and get started. All right, so we're gonna use the basic black for the base, and this is cut at 5.5 by 8.5, scored at 4.25. And then you're gonna need a piece of Real Red cardstock and the basic white, and these are both cut at 4 by 5.25. The Real Red is gonna go on the front, and then the basic white is gonna go on the inside. And then we're gonna also use the black and white designer paper. This paper comes in 12 by 12 sheets. It's in the holiday catalog, which starts on Friday, July 1st. And you're gonna cut a piece at 1.5 by 5. Okay, we're gonna grab our paper trimmer to score the end. So let me grab that. Okay, so let me just double check this is right. 1.5 by 5. Yep, so we're gonna score this at 4.25. Just score one end. That's it, and then you're just gonna fold this over. Okay, let me move the trimmer. All right, now we're gonna go ahead and do some die cutting, but I went ahead and did that already, but I wanna show you what you're gonna do. So you're gonna take your Real Red piece of cardstock that's gonna go on the front of your basic black. Now I would use some repositionable tape, or you could probably use some regular adhesive, just put it in the center, because you're gonna cut out the center with the circle, and then you'll just have to cut out another piece of basic black. At least that's what I'm using for my card. So I'm just gonna go ahead and use my repositionable tape and just position this right over top of the front of the card. And the repositionable tape keeps it in place so we can die cut it. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut it with the largest of the stylo shapes. Now I already cut mine out, but it's already on the card, so I'm just gonna show you what you're gonna do. So you're gonna take the largest of the stylo shape circle, and you're just gonna position this in the center of your card. If you want it more to the top, I mean, it's just a preference, whatever you wanna do, but I'm gonna position it right about there, and then I'm gonna open up the card base, and then I'm gonna go ahead and send that through the die cut machine. Okay, so it's gonna cut out the circle with the Real Red and the basic black. Okay, so now I went ahead and already did one, so let me grab that. Okay, so here's the one that I've already cut out, and you can tell I used the layering circles, and this circle is 3 inches around, all right? So this is from the layering circles that I used for this card. All right, and then you can tell I cut out both layers. Okay, and then my black layer, if you use the repositionable tape, you can reuse this. So I'm just gonna go ahead and take my finger and rub that across that glue that just comes right off when you rub it, because I'm gonna reuse this basic black piece. Okay, so the Real Red you can use for something else. And then I went ahead and cut out the stitched with the basic white, and I did that with the stylus shape, so I have that cute stitched edge. And I used it with this one, the next size down from the largest. So I went ahead and die cut that circle out. Okay, so that's where my Scottie's gonna go, my little dog. So cute. All right, so we went ahead and did all the die cutting. So now it's just a matter of putting the card together. But first, we're gonna go ahead and take our basic white piece, And we're also going to put this, if you want to use the repositionable tape on this section too, you can. I'm just going to go ahead and place it in there right where I want it. And then I'm going to go ahead and close the card. And then you can take a pencil. Let me grab my pencil. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to lightly draw the circle on the basic white. So I know exactly right where my flag or my pennant is going to go in the center, and then also to stamp the greeting on the inside of the card. Okay, so then you're going to set that aside. Now, before we put this onto the basic black, we're going to do some stamping. So let me grab my snowflakes. And the snowflakes are from the Christmas Scottie, and the snowflakes are right here. We're going to use the Real Red Classic Ink. We're going to stamp a tone on tone on the Real Red. And we're just going to stamp a few of the snowflakes along the top edge. This would be a really simple and really cute Christmas card. Really easy to mass produce. Okay, so now that we got our stamping done, now we can go ahead and put this onto the basic black piece. So let me go ahead and grab my adhesive. Okay, so remember we cut out the circle. So you want the circle to line up with the front of the card. But before we put this on, we're going to add some ribbon. So I have some black and white gingham ribbon. And I'm going to do something different with this one. I'm just going to go ahead and wrap it around to the front. And then I went ahead and tied a little bow to add on to the front with the glue dot. So I'm just going to wrap around the edges. Just like that. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and remove that from the card. Now we can go ahead and put this onto the basic black base. I'm going to open that up so I can see that circle, and it should line up perfectly. Right there. Looks really good. Okay. Now we're going to take that arm. We're going to take our paper snips and we're going to pin it. Now this is the end that we scored at 4 1/4. So we're going to take our end over here on the opposite side and we're going to flag the end, and you guys know I like to cut up the center and then I bring the points up to meet, so you get this really cute pennant like that. Then this edge right here is going to fold over to the back of the basic white, and then you're going to center that in the center of that circle that we traced on there with the pencil, and then you can see how this is going to go into the card like that. Okay, so let's go ahead and put this on the back, the adhesive. And you only want to put adhesive only on that scored end, just like that. And then you're just going to go ahead and slide that up so it's right up next to that basic white. And then center it over that circle. And then we can go ahead and put this onto the base. Okay, so then this arm is going to slide through that cutout in the front, just like that. Now, if you have directional paper, you want to make sure that it's going the right way when the card is sitting closed like this. And then for the circle that we cut out for the front, remember we cut through the basic black and the Real Red, we're going to go ahead and put this right onto that designer paper. So we're only going to put our adhesive on that star designer paper. And then the circle should fit right into that circle cutout perfectly, just like that. And then you might want to open it up to push it through. And then you have your flap right there. Isn't it adorable? All right, now we're going to go ahead and punch our little dog out. So let me get my black cardstock. And then I'm also using the Real Red for the bow. And the dog and the bow are both on the punch. So we're going to punch out our dog right there, and then I'm going to punch out the little bow, which is right here, right above the little dog. It goes flying. I'm going to go ahead and use my black mini dimensionals. I'm going to put the bow right onto the dog. I think I'm gonna have him go like this, right? And then put the bow onto the dog, and then we're gonna flip that over. We're gonna put two dimensionals on him. And then this is the white circle. Remember, this one is cut at 2.5. This is from the Stylish Shapes. And I'm gonna go ahead and put this right onto that black circle that's in the center. It's just a smidge smaller, just like that. And then we're gonna pop the little Scottie dog up in the center. So cute. All right, now we're gonna add our bow. And I went ahead and tied the bow with the black and white gingham ribbon. So let me grab a glue dot. I'm gonna put a glue dot onto the ribbon here. I'm actually gonna kind of pinch this together just a little bit so it looks like I actually tied it so it gathers. So you might need a few, like I think I'm using 3 little mini glue dots here. Just gonna pinch it just like that. And then we're gonna take our bow. I'm just gonna put that right onto the front. And then I'm gonna trim the tails a little bit more. The bow makes it, doesn't it? It's so cute and festive. All right, now we're gonna go ahead and stamp the inside of the card. Remember, we still have our circle here, so we know right where to stamp. So I have my greeting. This is really cute. It says, "May your days be furry and bright." I'm gonna use the Memento Tuxedo Black. And this is a photopolymer stamp set, so you can see exactly right where you're stamping. And I'm gonna stamp it right in the center of this. Well, you wanna make sure it's between the flap so it gets covered up. So you wanna leave your circle on there until after you stamp. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and stamp it right about there. Okay, and then we're gonna take our eraser and I'm gonna erase my circle. So let me go ahead and do that. So you can see, let me close up my ink pad before I make a mess. Okay, so you can see that the greeting gets covered up with the little flap. And that's gonna go on the inside of the cutout. And then one more thing, we're gonna add some red rhinestones, just one to the larger of the snowflakes. I'm gonna use my Take Your Pick tool. You can put them on all the snowflakes, but I just like the one. Okay, I think that's it. Isn't that cute? You can also put one on the bow too of the dog. So cute. So there's your Christmas Scottie fun flat fold card. So adorable. Okay, so let me show you the other ones again. Okay, so here's the first one. And then here's the one with the hippest hippos. Love you a ton. And then it says, "Ah, you really are the best." Oh, and then I did the mask. If you guys remember last week in the glitter pit, when we stamped this card live with the glasses and stuff, we added the window sheet. Somebody had mentioned that I could just cut out the mask and then add the frame over the window sheet. It was so much easier that way. So I just want to do a shout out to whoever that was that shared that tip with me. I love it. So that's what I did with the little mask or the goggles. So cute. All right, and then also I have a PDF that's listed down below in the description box, but these items, which are the two stamp sets, the Hippest Hippos and the Christmas Scottie, I can't add them to the PDF, but all the measurements and all the other supplies that I used on both of these cards are listed down below on the PDF, all right? So if you have any questions, please let me know. I'll have all the items listed down below, and if you like today's video, give me a thumbs up. Okay, I'll see you later. Bye.